Hello, this is Oleg from Experimental Avionics, and today I'm going to show you how to assemble the display unit. To assemble the display unit, you need all these parts that you can see on your screen right now. And if you purchase the kit from Experimental Avionics online store, you probably received it in the package. To assemble the display unit, you need the main board here, Arduino Mega in its this smaller package, CAN bus adapter, few female and male headers, DB9 connector, and a few nuts and bolts. Okay, let's start with attaching the Arduino board to the main board. So now we need to attach the headers to the main board and the Arduino board. We'll attach male headers to the main board, like that, and female headers to the Arduino board. So here how we do it. So we break away a few pins like that. And some more. And I recommend to solder these pins to the board with the Arduino board somewhat attached to the board. I'll show you what I mean. So we get corresponding female headers aligned with the board like this. And here's a trick how to get the female headers attached and cut from the longer strip. So what I do, I measure how many I need and cut right here, right over the pin. We kind of sacrifice this pin for this purpose. All right, it flies away. And we just clean it up a little. And there we have it. That's one. Another one a little shorter. Again, cut it right over the pin. This one going here, and this one going here, like that. Now that we have all the pins ready, we put them on top of each other, connect them together. Like that. Okay, so we put together boards like this. We haven't soldered them yet, so now it's a good time to solder them on each side, holding the boards together with just your fingers, like that. Now we soldered this side of the board, of Arduino board. Now we can solder the pins on the main board, right here. After we finish soldering these pins, we can disconnect boards one from another like that. They sit together a bit tight, but that's actually a good thing. There you go. So you can always replace the board, one Arduino board, and with another. Next step would be attaching the CAN bus board. Note that this board attached upside down. So this is the board, and it also shortened a little bit. To shorten the board, first thing we need to do is to remove this terminal here. Then we need to cut these pins here, just like that. We don't need them. If we need to use a terminating resistor here, we just shorten these pins on this side. And these pins we need. I use belt grinder to remove a little bit of the board from here up to the holes, like up to the mounting holes here. So the board becomes like this. Okay, it's shortened. To attach this CAN board to the main display board, we just put it through the holes like that. And solder on this side. That's basically how it is done. And here we have the board already soldered in. And of course we also need to attach this 20 pin female connector on other side of the board, right here. This and solder all the pins. And of course we need to solder in this trim pot and CAN bus DB9 connector, 9 pin connector, like this. And now we just put Arduino board back in. And we're ready to roll. Next step would be attaching the standoffs to mount the display, actual LCD display, to this board. We use 1 millimeter spacer here to make sure that we don't stress the connectors when we put them together. It's better to have a little bit of a gap when connectors between the board and displays connected. And now we can connect the display. Display has all male headers attached to it on this side of the board. And now that's it. Almost done. Now we'll put a temporary screw here to hold it together. Now, depending of your installation plans, how and where you want to have this display attached, you might need to have a spacer between this board and the encoder. So if you attach encoder directly on the board like this, it might be a bit too short. So there is a spacer here. That you put like this, and it extends the reach of the encoder like that. So what you do first, you attach your encoder on the spacer like that, this side where it says encoder. Let's see if it focus right here, encoder too. And optionally you can attach the toggle switch here. And then what you do, you break away pins one at a time like this. And also five. Like that. And you solder these pins to the spacer like this. Five on this side, then two here, and two here. So you solder them here and here. This is how the spacer looks like after all the pins soldered in here. And now what we do, we just solder the spacer to the main board like this. Put it through the holes. We just guide the spacer pins through the corresponding holes on the main board and align the board like this. Usually, well, the way I did it on my dashboard, I left just a little bit on the other side of the pins here, just they protrude just a little bit, maybe half a millimeter above the board surface, and I align them like this and just solder them in here and to here and to here, and that's it. This display board has optional LEDs and toggle switch installed. Toggle switch basically switches between EFIS display and engine management system display. So the CPU on this board is capable to handle both. So for redundancy purposes, it makes sense to install it, and depends on what option or what functionality do you need. You can switch between them easily. And LEDs are just for some warning purposes. I haven't finished writing software for them, but eventually they will be utilized one way or another. So that's about it for display board. It's pretty simple. It should take about 30 minutes or 40 minutes to put it together. Depends on your soldering skills. So give it a try and good luck.